Right now, you're looking at a rendering of a nuclear-powered tunneling robot designed to find life on Europa. It looks like an Alaskan bullworm. At the American Geophysical Union's conference in December 2018, scientists gathered from around the world to present their concepts for future space missions. There were dragonfly-inspired drones for Titan, probes designed to take the temperature of Io's volcanoes, but perhaps the coolest of them all was a tunneling worm robot designed to bore through Europa's icy shell. The bot was designed by NASA's Compass team, a group of engineers tasked with ideating system designs for space exploration missions. And Jupiter's icy moon Europa is a prime target because, well, there might be life there. For years, scientists have suspected Europa has an iron core, a rocky mantle, and a global ocean of liquid water. And in 2013, the Hubble Space Telescope observed possible evidence of plumes of water on Europa's surface, suggesting that it's geologically active. Scientists even think there could be hydrothermal vents on its sea floor, supporting all kinds of alien life. So obviously we want to go there and take a swim, but the oceans lie beneath an estimated 15 to 25 kilometers of ice, which makes exploring them a challenge. That's where the tunneling robot comes in. About 5 meters in length, the robot is covered with hot plates that would melt the ice during its descent into the deep unknown. On board, the bot would carry all sorts of instruments and equipment, allowing it to take samples as it goes. It would also have cables or a flotation device to keep it from sinking once it reaches Europa's ocean, so it can just hang there, sticking its nose into the alien Bikini Bottom. All the data gathered would then be transmitted via fiber optic cables back to a lander at the surface. Oh yeah, and the whole thing is either powered by general purpose heat source bricks containing plutonium, or an onboard nuclear reactor. Pretty rad. General purpose heat source modules rely on the radioactive decay of plutonium, and they've been used frequently in NASA missions. But the US hasn't launched a nuclear fission reactor since 1965. For the last few years, though, they've been revisiting fission with their kilopower project, an effort to find affordable nuclear fission systems that could provide the increased power needed for space travel. Kilopower systems are already being tested, so it's possible a future iteration could be used for the nuclear worm bot. Which brings us to the question, what's the timeline for this project? When will the big worm get to fly? Well, NASA's Europa Clipper mission is slated for sometime in the 2020s, but as of now, that mission only includes an orbiter, and for the tunneling worm to be used, there would need to be a lander. NASA has hinted at a possible Europa Lander mission, but there's nothing concrete yet. That being said, the probe was commissioned by NASA, so there's clearly interest in the feasibility of a design like this. And with the tantalizing possibility of finding life on Europa, it's probably only a matter of time before we try to peek under its shell. But in the meantime, I guess we can hope a Hollywood director has seen these sketches and is gonna make a kick-ass sci-fi movie about tunneling alien robots. I would definitely watch that. Want more videos about insane space mission designs from the Compass team? Let us know in the comments. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.